Jesus loves me, this I know.
For the kidding,
the Bible tells me so. Where the ones to him belong, they are weak, but he is strong. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. The Bible tells me so.
Are we doing fellowship service?
the Seminoles? Are we going to do that? No? Okay, so we'll still have some fellowship. That's okay. We'll still meet if we want. We just want to have some Seminoles. So. And then Wednesday and Thursday, 6 o'clock, Wednesday's Bible study, and then the hymn sing along is Thursday. And then there are some new flyers here for May and then June. They're out there on a little podium out there if you need one. We're still doing the monthly meal for Sparrow House. Did you want to talk about that? Yeah. Was that just recently?
It was Thursday.
Yeah. You want it?
Sure.
Thanks.
Well, we had lots of spaghetti.
Yeah.
And I want to thank everybody. Haven't decided what we're going to do for sure next month, but we'll come up with something. Thank you, everybody, for their help.
Awesome. Well, thank you, everybody. Yes. And then, let's see. So we still have our nursery for the younger kids, and then don't forget your usual Sunday giving. We have the second, well, the Soupy Sunday, Mission Sunday, Fruity Sunday, and Meaty Sunday. And then I just want to touch in May, looking ahead, the men's ministry will be meeting twice a month now, so every other Saturday. So that's great. And then we have the church cleanup for the men on the 4th. So whatever that is, whatever you guys are doing, I want to also just thank Michelle and Roy for mowing her. And who? And Al. Yes, Al. Sorry, brother. I love you. Thanks for mowing and taking care of the kids. So God bless you guys for that. Thank you. And then on the 6th, we have the women's ministry, and there was a date change for our ladies' tea. So. Just if you're looking at our list with all the events, just know that those dates can change. And the ladies' tea will now be on Saturday, May 11th at 2 o'clock. And then at 5, that's when we'll have our bluegrass. It'll be a busy day. Okay? That's all I have for events. Are there any other events or announcements?
Back here.
Yes, sir.
My friend Bill, he's not good, and he's going to die, my friend.
All right. Is he safe? Well, we'll be praying for you to have the opportunity to talk about Jesus, okay?
Yeah, this may do.
All right. Okay, so we're moving on to prayer requests. Does anyone else have any prayer requests or praises? You have a prayer request? Okay, let's hear it.
Our friend Ina is not doing well. She's in the hospital, but they're going to move her to a rehab facility.
All right, absolutely. Grandma Ina?
Ina.
All right. I also have a prayer request from David to pray for Israel. And then from the church, we have Decaloris for the women's that is coming up and the Deco Tech. The men's weekend, I went for closing for that, and that was amazing. So not everybody that goes to Decaloris, not everyone knows the Lord. So we've had some people that accepted Jesus as their Savior and had some bondage broken. It was a great closing. No other prayer requests. Okay, let's pray. Gracious Heavenly Father, Lord, we just thank you for your Holy Spirit. Thank you for being here and meeting us, Lord, wherever we are. Thank you, Lord, for the blessings that you've given us. Thank you, Lord, for Marie. Lord, we just want to lift her up to you right now. All the prayer requests, Lord. Just be with her. Give her peace as she speaks, Lord. Just let her speak from her heart. Thank you, and we love you. And Lord, just give Pastor safe travels home, too. We love you, and thank you. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Oh, I forgot to show you guys something. I have a bracelet here.
Oh, did you get that made?
Yes. It says Jesus Fest. So that's coming up, and then we have Acts 13:44, where we all come together and worship together.
Yeah.
So, awesome. All right. All right, Dad, go ahead.
Some glad morning when life is on, I'll fly away to a home on God's celestial shore. I'll fly away. I'll fly away, oh glory. I'll fly away in the morning when I die. Hallelujah, by and by.
Forever, forever, forever.
His grace we will carry on. His love endures forever. Sing praise, sing praise, sing praise, sing praise. Forever God is faithful, forever God is strong, forever God is with us, forever. What can wash away my sin? Not but the blood of Jesus. What can make me whole again? Not but the blood of Jesus. Oh, precious is the flow that makes me last. Nothing but the blood of Jesus.
Well, good morning, everyone. How are you? All right. So today we're going to talk about the Good Shepherd. But before we start, I just want to tell you when I was growing up, my sisters and I, the one type of animal we raised and that we showed at the fair was sheep. And it was actually the very first animal that I showed. And we had a baby sheep that, oh, I love this sheep, because the sheep recognized our voices, and it was the only sheep that was allowed to be outside of the pen, because the sheep literally followed us all around the farm as we were doing our chores. It never wandered off, it followed us. And I loved that sheep. So today, what we are gonna do, we're gonna do an activity. What I'd like to do is I'd like to have two of you to have a blindfold on, okay? The other two are going to be somewhere somewhere in the church here. But honestly, guys, I don't want you too far away, because I don't want you to run into anything, okay? If this makes sense. So the person that has the blindfold on, I'm going to have you guys pair up. So the one person is going to call out the other one's name, the one that has the blindfold on, okay? So the job is to find the person that's calling you, okay? So basically following their voice, okay? Now, purposely, it's okay, the ones that are calling, if you're a little too loud and the person might have trouble hearing you, okay? That's okay. I'm going to let you girls do the way you want to. So I'm going to put the microphone down so we can decide who wants to have the handkerchief on and who wants to be the person calling out the name, okay? Mm-hmm. Tanya, I might have you just be up here to make sure no one bumps into something.
Okay.
And girls, I promise you, if you can, Miss Tanya, I'm going to have you help to make sure that, because the ones that are blindfolded, you're going to have to like walk towards, and we don't want them to bump into anything. Yeah. So, and I want the girls to trust us. So, okay. So the other two, why don't you go ahead and stand up for me? And so you need to call the one girl. Go ahead and call out their names. Okay. But they need to be able to hear you, so you can't just say, I mean, you have, so they can hear you, okay? So don't be shy. I work at a school, I know kids can be loud.
Yeah.
Okay, so girls, go ahead. Try to call them out.
Ava.
Keep calling.
All right, I like I said, I just wanted the girls to get an idea. So as we're untying these blindfolds, I want you girls to answer. I want you to answer honestly. Okay, so do you think having the blindfolds on, do you think it was easy to try to follow their voice? No. Okay. Do you think it was easy to hear their voice? Okay, so you thought it was easy to hear their voice. Ava, how about you? Do you think, I mean, honestly, and there's no right or wrong answer, honey. So whatever you feel. Was it easy to hear Savannah's voice? You don't know? Okay. So, what I want to read from you right now is John 10, verses 2 through 5. And it says, "The man who enters by the gate is the shepherd of his sheep. The watchman opens the gate for him, and the sheep listen to his voice. He calls his own sheep by name and leads them out." So my question is, based on the Bible, who do you think the shepherd is? Who do you think the shepherd is that's calling out the sheep to try to follow him? Jesus. Yes, Ava, you're right, it was Jesus. Now, who's the shepherds? Honestly, it's all of us. All of us, Jesus is wanting us to follow his voice. Because there might be other people in the world that love you, but Jesus knows what's best for you. Jesus is never going to lead you in a place that's hurtful or that he can't help you. There's no way, guys. There's no way. So Jesus, we need more than just to believe in Jesus. We must be willing to listen to Jesus, but most importantly, live a life that is pleasing to Jesus. Okay? I know I say that a lot on Sundays about living the life that's pleasing to him. And girls, I'll tell you, it's not just for your ears, but it's for everybody's ears. Amen. That's what's pleasing to Jesus, is whether we're little kids or we're adults. We need to live a life pleasing to God, pleasing to Jesus, and we need to be willing to listen when he speaks. Okay, now we're going to go ahead, stand in a circle, and we're going to pray.
Good morning, church.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Let's profess our faith by reciting together the Wesleyan Prayer. I am no longer my own, but yours.
Put me to what you will. Place me to whom you will. Put me to doing. Put me to suffering. Let me be put to work for you, or set aside for you. Praise for you, or criticized for you. Let me be full. Let me be empty. Let me have all things. Let me have nothing. I freely and fully surrender all things to your glory and service. And now, O wonderful and God, Creator, Redeemer, and Sustainer, you are mine, and I am yours. So be it. And the covenant which I made on earth, let also be made in heaven.
Amen.
Michelle.
That one. That one.
Here.
Encore,
all right.
Woohoo! Woohoo! Let's go.
Where's the music coming from?
So far, so good. Need some help, Chris.
You're up.
I never heard that.
Don't be scared.
That I know this. All faded. But I'm not faded. All things. I do all things because God is my strength.
No.
And I'm going to cry. Mm-hmm. Just that.
We get to the microphone.
This is my favorite. It says the Lord is my strength and shield. I trust him with all my heart. Mm-hmm. And then I have one more. It's Galatians.
We love you.
Galatians. Verse 13. So I can do all things through Christ because he gives me my strength, just like this says. Like, and that's how I believe that God is the one that gives me my strength to stand up here.
Yeah.
And I thank him. I've talked to him many nights since I was asked to do this. And he answered me because I feel comfortable now with the grace of my beautiful family, friends, sisters praying for me prior to. I shall never let you down. God never let me down. I'm not going to let you down because I love God. Okay, I'm going to start out by saying I'm just a good old country girl. They took me out of the country, but they couldn't take country out of the country. Start in the beginning, and I have many, many reasons to do, and thank God. Some of them went back when I was just a baby, the very first one that I remember. My mom and dad were having a quarrel. We lived in an upstairs apartment. I was a baby. I didn't know anything, of course. My mom and dad got into a fight because my daddy came home drunk in place of coming home after work. So to get back at him, she picked me up and threw me down the steps. And my father caught me. I was told this by the family. So there was my first saved from God. Being saved as I was being thrown down the steps. And then as I grew up, there was many things that came and I was saved by God. One of them was when we were on our way home from school. My brothers were fighting who was going to get out of the car first. Well, I was to sit at one door and my oldest brother at the other door. Well, my brother that was next to me reached over and hit that door handle, and out I went. I hit the culprit. I have a big scar on my head. But guess who was with me? When I didn't realize that God was with me. Mm-hmm. But he was. He was. And there's so many different things that happened in my life. It's hard to get it. At all of them. And as a child, my mother was jealous of me. So she would do mean things to me lots of times. But I forgive my mother like God wants me to. Other than throwing me down the steps, she never once told me she loved me. And I was always the one that had to take the brunt of all things that happened because my brothers outnumbered me. And if they said so, then it was true to my mama. But that's all right. God just made me stronger. Not knowing it, but he did. And And as I got older, and I got married when I was 16. Horrible, don't do that, girls. I married a gentleman that was, he's my children's father. We fathered, and we had five children in all. I lost one child at the age of, just before I turned 30, and one baby when he was 3 weeks old. The main arteries to his heart was reversed. I came home brokenhearted for my other children, but knew that I still had my family at home that I had to take care of. And that I raised my beautiful family. And now I'm blessed again with many, many grandchildren. Well, grandchildren, and they multiply. I have 49 great-great-grandchildren. Well, that's not just the list of it. I have 35 great-great-grandchildren. Tell me God don't bless me. I have been blessed many, many times. And every time, I'm going to get a new one. Yes, in July, I get a new one. So that made me 50. That's so awesome. I cherish that, and that's a lot of things that happened. And when I was young, I loved going to church. Wanted to go to church. I wanted to go to school, but I wasn't. I was in the ninth grade, and my mom and dad decided that a girl didn't need her education. So I was forced to quit school, stay home, and take care of children, the younger ones. There again, God helped me through it. Like he's like, did I know it? No, I know it now. You know all the things that happened to me and what I lived through. God was always with me. And I love him from the bottom of my heart. And I praise him every day. I've had problems many times with finding at home and keeping my children safe because their father and I were divorced. He was very, very brutally mean to me again. And God was there. I left him. And therefore, I raised my children by myself without any help from their dad. But I always worked, always had a job, always had plenty. We never lacked for anything. And most of all, I didn't lack for love because I was granted the biggest heart full of love by God that anybody could get. And I still have that big heart full of love. I give it to all of you. Each and every one of you, when I say I love you, I really, really mean it because that's what God gave me, was a heart full of love. I praise him for that. And then I must bring up the fact that I have two daughters and one son, and now I have three daughters. Well, I actually have four because I raised a granddaughter. That is my daughter also, and she has four beautiful babies, three boys and a little girl. That's the light of grandma's heart. Again, my daughter here, and she's my daughter. I love her. I couldn't love her more if I gave birth to her. She's the greatest thing, one of the greatest things God gave me. And he did. Very special person. She wasn't supposed to have a baby, but she did. And I told my husband, I said, if I didn't know better, I just know Kim's pregnant. She waddled. You know how to waddle. 2 days later, we had a baby girl. Yes, ma'am. 2 days later, we had a baby girl. Our baby was born at home. my brother, my son here, my loving son, he calls me, Mother, Mother, come. And Brian was fond of dogs and cats and fish, and he was always, when they were having babies, Mama had to come see him. So I went running over there. He said, Mama, Mama, we have a boy. We have a boy. I said, Brian, I don't want to know about your dogs. I just got to go to work in the morning. That boy was a big girl when I got there. They were standing in the bathroom with this gorgeous little baby in their arm. This gorgeous doll baby. Kim, God bless her heart. But God kept her from bleeding, and you know, after birth, you bleed. She did not. And my son, I told my husband before I left, call 911, because I heard a baby cry. He called 911, I beat the ambulance there, but the ambulance came in, and they took the baby. I took the baby. I had been over to her house because she hadn't felt good that day. Let me get back to that. She didn't feel good. And I said, well, honey, then don't go to work. So I went over, and I gave her some liquid to make her have a bowel movement because she said her tummy hurt. And you'll imagine that she's in pain to have a child. But I didn't know if it was a suspicion I had, but I didn't know. But there again, who was there for us? God was there. And I come in and she's standing there holding the baby, and I had went over that night and I made supper for them. And I put clean towels out and I cleaned things up. And there again, why did I do that? Because there was a reason. God had a reason for me to do that. I went in there, and there she stood with my beautiful baby. The baby was starting to turn blue, lips, because she wasn't breathing. My sweetheart there, she didn't know what to do. She handed me the baby. I turned her on her side, like I've seen Doc Corey do when he delivered the babies at home. And I got her to breathe. I took my finger and took this out of her mouth. And I got her to breathe, and I reached over, grabbed that towel that I had put up, swallowed my baby in a towel. I said, Brian, go get a blanket, hurry. So we got a blanket, we covered her up with it. We wrapped her up with it, and I walked beside her because we had the cord. And that's why Brian thought he had a little boy. He didn't know that was the baby's umbilical cord. And he brought the blanket, and we walked her in there, me carrying a little swaddled baby. We got to sit down. She never had a drop of blood. Not once. By then, the ambulance was there. And they were amazed about what they had just gone through. And so Brian, him being the father, got over there. I believe you cut the cord, didn't you, son?
Nope.
They wouldn't let him.
At that part, I didn't remember. But I know the cord was cut there. And then we rushed her to the hospital. And the rest is history, as far as I'm concerned, because if I wouldn't have been there, and willing my husband and I to take the baby, they would have taken our baby and put her in an orphanage, or, you know, they take the baby from them when they have special needs. They don't get a choice. We had a beautiful doctor, that Dr. Craigill and Dr. Hunter was their name. The Hunter was the lady, and Dr. Craigill was the man that was taking care of her, took care of the afterbirth and everything that hadn't even come out yet. And he took care of her. Dr. Hunter took care of our darling baby girl. There, and I just know God was there. Without God, how would we have been able to do that? We didn't have the knowledge to do all the things that we've done that very night. And our baby was special. She's beautiful. And when I found out they planned on taking my baby, no, you're not. Mm-mm-mm. My husband says, no way. The doctor Dr. Hunter. She was another godsend. She says, don't worry about it, Grandma. We'll go home with you. They will not take this baby. And they didn't. Brian and Kim had always been mom and dad. It was always a part of her life. I made sure of that. I made sure that she knew that mom and dad loved her with all their heart. But I raised her on my own, like I did my other children. She's a fabulous young lady now. She's a juvenile correctional agent in South Bend. Very well thought of. Going to be a CO. She's just doing great. And she's got these three boys and one beautiful little girl. There again, I am so blessed. So blessed. And God, I just can't tell enough about how God has worked in my life, even before I was wise enough to know that God was in my life. But now that I know, I cherish it. I cherish the fact that God's with me. I love feelings that I get. And I'm getting one right now because I'm getting that goosebumps. And when I get goosebumps, that means God's with me. It's a wonderful feeling, but it's... I don't know if there's much more that I had to talk about, except that my brothers and I, we were very, very close. I have lots and lots of nieces and nephews and cousins and aunts and uncles. I only had my sister that's left out of the eight children that we had in our family. She's a smoker. I know that she could die if she keeps smoking.
Yep, I told her stop.
No, we do. And I said, you need to stop smoking, sis. She said, well, I know I'm going to die when God's acting, when it's time for God to take me home. I'll die. So I might as well be happy while I'm here. That's the way you want to feel. You go for it. I saved your life, young lady, because I called in. She had 24 hours to live. I called in, talked to a nurse, told that nurse what was happening, and sure enough, that's what was happening. He called the urologist in, the urologist come in, checked the catheter. The catheter was bent, and he was able to take care of it. The next morning, she came awake, and she had septus. She was filled with fluid around her heart. She was in, they only gave her 24 hours, but she just had some aching problems. He took that catheter out. The next morning, she woke up, and she says, I want a cup of coffee and a cigarette. And I thank God for her being alive. And she's putting more poison in her system. Can't get it. You're going to meet her because she's coming home in July, and I told her she's coming to my grandma's church. She will. And I have a little lady that went there that looks so much like her. I think about her every time I see her. She's just a little bit tinier. But I want you all to know that I'm just so blessed. Brothers and I would go hunting. And I was no bigger than a minute, believe that. Yeah, I wasn't no bigger than a minute. We went hunting this one time, and there was this beaver's nest there. Well, we knew there was rabbits in there, okay? And we always bring rabbits home. Well, we had four shells and me. I said me because I'd get up on that beaver's dam and jump. Well, when I jumped, the rabbits came out. Two brothers, they had their clubs, they clubbed them. Well, needless to say, we went home with three rabbits and one bullet. Three bullets and one rabbit, Anyhow, we went home with three rabbits. And the bullets were still Mom and Dad were surprised that we did that. We got scolded a little bit because they was afraid we could have gotten her. I could have, by my brothers doing that. But, well, again, I didn't know, but God was with me. I could have got her. Now, He's got a purpose for me. Mm-hmm. I believe God has a purpose for me. And I know one of them is He filled my heart with love. And I have a heart for love. And I want to give it to each and every one of you, some of my love. And when I greet you, when you come in, it's the most wonderful feeling to greet you, give you a hug, and let you know that you are loved and that you are part of family when you join our church. And we are a family church. I love all my family. When I walked in, there he is again. He's with me. When I walked through that door, my beautiful children here, Mom, you've got to come to church. I had gone to another church and things didn't go well there, so I just didn't go. And I knew it was time to go back. I hadn't been baptized in Niles when I was on January 17th. Don't ask me what year because my little mind don't know that. But I know what day it was. Because I had a grandson born that day. Great grandson. So that was a blessing. So God blessed me then, and He blessed me with another baby. So I'm trying to think of some of the other things, and there's so many things I could just keep rambling on for the rest of the day, but I do want to thank Pastor for giving me a chance and thinking that I can do this. And because he had enough faith in me, and I knew God would be with me, I said yes. Aww. We have a wonderful Pastor, one of the greatest. He loves us all, and we all love him. So I want to just thank you all for listening to me. Most of all, I thank God.
Hey,
the little puppy dog thinks he always chimes in when it comes time for that. Thank you for listening. God bless all of you. Must have done that because he just wanted me to talk from my heart.
Amen.
Right?
Yeah.
There he is again. Mm-hmm. And that's what I did. I obeyed God. Thank you.
You make so much noise for us. You have something to say.
Thank you.
service. Marie, thanks for your words. Please let everybody at the end of the service come into Fellowship Hall, have a little fellowship, cup of coffee, or whatever else may happen to be in there. We'll count on seeing you then. Let us pray. Lord, thank you for this day. Thank you for the wonderful service. Thank you for your love, and thank you for your Son, Jesus Christ. And we pray this in his holy name. Amen. Father God Almighty, blessed are thee we know, living on your prairie, this farmland is our home. Whatsoever comes, our faith. Let's pray.